Next, if someone collapsed in the street and stopped breathing, would you know how to help? Well, new research says that more than half of Londoners wouldn't know how to perform CPR, which is used to resuscitate someone after a cardiac arrest. Now there's a drive to help change that, and it starts with school children. Emilia Papadopoulos can tell us more and joins us from Great Ormond Street Hospital. Emilia.
Yes, Rose. Well, here at Great Ormond Street, more than 300 children have learnt how to perform CPR today. Now, we'll be finding out just how it works in a few minutes. But first, let's see how those school children got on.
You need to pump that heart, which is pumping what around the body?
Oxygen.
Oxygen. Perfect. That's what you need to do.
A lesson in life-saving at a school in Lewisham. For one pupil, it's already come in handy. A few months ago, 14-year-old Sarah saved her dad's life after he went into cardiac arrest at home. She was only able to do so because she'd learnt CPR at school 2 weeks earlier.
I just thought back to when I saw the mannequin, because my dad was lying down on the floor. So it reminded me of seeing the mannequin. And then I just started remembering what I had been taught on that lesson. Then I just put it into action on my dad.
You saved your dad's life.
Yeah. When we got to the A&E, one of the paramedics came up to me and he said that if it wasn't for you, we would have never had a chance of getting him back. So after that, I knew that I did the right thing and I was proud of what I did.
Today, school children across the capital watched and learnt how CPR works. It's part of a scheme to get more people trained and help save lives. Last year, there were more than 4,000 out-of-hospital cardiac arrests. Only 9% of people survived them. And when you think that more than half of Londoners have never had CPR training, it's not hard to see why this skill is vital to all age groups.
If you look at all the causes of premature death, this is the one which will be very, very easy to solve. If you look back to the original paper describing CPR, all that is needed is two hands. And it's so cheap to be able to deliver this sort of training. And I'd love the Secretary of State for Education to become a lifesaver herself and mandate this so that all London and all of the UK can learn this vital skill.
11-year-old Cade had a heart attack while swimming. He was saved by CPR and now wants all young people to know how to do it.
It's such a great skill to have. Everyone from year six and on should do it because you never know when it could happen to anyone. Like, you can have fire or you can have it through the family.
CPR can double a person's chance of survival, and though resuscitating someone sounds daunting, this training hopes to give people the confidence to step in and try.
I'm pleased to say I'm joined now by Dr. Andy Lockie from Resuscitation Council UK. Now, it does look a little bit complicated, but it's actually quite simple, and you're going to show us how it all works.
It's very simple. Children can learn this in less than half an hour, and it truly helps to save a life. Essentially, if somebody's collapsed in front of you, what we need is to make sure it's safe to approach, and once you've approached, see if the person is responding. If they're not responding, we then need to see if they're breathing normally or not, and to do that, we would open the airway by doing a head tilt and chin lift, and then looking, listening, and feeling for up to 10 seconds for any normal breathing. If there's no normal breathing, it's essential that somebody calls the emergency services and gets an ambulance on the way. And then the critical thing is to start chest compressions. To do that, it's the heel of one hand in the centre of the chest, the other hand on top, vertically above with the elbows locked, and compressing for about 5 centimetres depth at a rate of 120 per minute, which is approximately the speed of Staying Alive by the Bee Gees. And you do 30 compressions, and then if you're able, 2 ventilations, and keep repeating that. If you're not able to do ventilations, then 30, just keep doing compressions.
So people just, you have to keep doing the compressions until the emergency services arrive?
Yes. By doing chest compressions, you're buying that person time until either the emergency services arrive, or if there is a defibrillator nearby, a public access defibrillator, and someone brings that, you may actually be able to save the life even before then.
And a lot of people might be frightened of hurting the patient or the person that's collapsed even more. What would you say to people that might not have the confidence to perform CPR?
You can do no harm. If somebody's collapsed, unconscious, not breathing normally, you can do no harm, but quite the opposite, you can actually save their life.
Thank you very much, Dr. Andy Lockie. Now, even though it does look a bit daunting, it's definitely a skill worth learning. You never know, you could save someone's life.
Absolutely, really helpful. From Great Ormond Street, Emilia, thanks very much indeed.